Hello everyone, in this video we'll be talking about ultrasonic sensors and its applications. So let's get started. The basic principle behind the ultrasonic sensor is that the emitter emits ultrasonic waves which when bounced back from the concerned object are received by the receiver, and by which we come to know the time lag between the wave going and coming back. Then we can simply calculate the distance between the concerned object and the receiver by the formula twice of distance is equal to time into speed of sound, which we already know. The latest fingerprint scanners are based on ultrasonic technology. It uses ultrasonic sound waves to capture sensitive 3D images. Highly sensitive surface map of the finger are formed, which cannot be easily imitated. Stronger material penetration is also a great feature of this technology. It can penetrate 400 micron glass and 400 micron metal. The greatest thing about this technology is that even though some common contaminants like sweat, lotion, or dust might be present on the finger, still the fingerprint scanner would work flawlessly.
Another application of ultrasonic waves is sonar. Sonar stands for sound navigation and ranging. It is a technique that uses sound propagation to navigate, communicate with, or detect objects. Sonar can also be used to see what is beneath the waves. Sonar sends out rapid sound pulses that bounces off the seafloor and back to scan what's below. These soundings produce amazingly detailed pictures of the unseen seafloor.
Next is ultrasonic flow measuring principle. Various substances are transported using pipelines. These substances include solvents and chemicals, vegetable oil and petrochemical products. The flow is measured using ultrasonic flow meter. There are various pairs of sensors which alternately send and receive ultrasonic signals and simultaneously measure the transit time. First, piezoelectric crystals generate an ultrasonic signal which is received by another crystal at another ultrasonic sensor, which subsequently generates a voltage signal. When there is no flow, the upstream and downstream time are same. When the fluid flows, the transit time for downstream is less as compared by transit time for upstream. The difference in transit time is directly proportional to the flow velocity. If the area of cross-section is known, the volume of fluid crossing a particular cross-section can be calculated. Thus, we can calculate the flow rate of the fluid.
So, thank you for watching this video. If you liked it, click on the like button.